Hello friends. Today we're going to talk about an interesting device for plant care, a sensor that measures air temperature and soil moisture. It has a special probe that is inserted into the soil, and with its help, you can not only monitor the condition of your plants, but also set up automatic notifications about the need for watering. And if the system includes controllable valves or actuators, it's even possible to fully automate the watering process. The sensor operates via the Zigbee protocol, which is known for its low power consumption. This means the device can run on batteries for a long time and doesn't require wiring. We will also check the sensor's compatibility with various smart home management systems. Tuya Smart, operation via Matter with Apple HomeKit, Google Home, and Home Assistant, connection to the Sonoff iHost controller, and support in JA and Zigbee 2 MQTT. More on all of this later, but for now, as usual, I ask you to like this video so it can reach more people interested in smart home technology and to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type: sensor for measuring soil temperature and humidity. Model: SGS01Z. Interface: Zigbee 3.0. Air temperature: from minus 20 to 60 degrees Celsius. Soil moisture measurement range: from 0 to 100%. Power supply: 2 AAA batteries. Battery life on one set: from 8 to 12 months. Size: sensor: 77.5 by 33.5 by 21 millimeters. Probe: 84.5 by 30 millimeters. The sensor comes in a small cardboard box with a color image of the device. I didn't find any manufacturer logos, ecosystems, or interface markings. The only identifying marks are the model name on one side, since these sensors are also available with Bluetooth and Wi-Fi interfaces, and a sticker indicating that this is the Zigbee version. The package included only the sensor itself with a light blue silicone case and a small instruction manual. There were no batteries in my set, so you'll need to get those separately. The manual is in English and consists of just 6 small pages. A useful tip is that the probe should be inserted into the soil at least 2/3 of its length, while the main body of the sensor should not be submerged or exposed to water. To pair the device, hold down the button until the LED starts blinking. I'll demonstrate this a bit later. The device consists of 2 parts: the sensor itself, which is a module measuring 77.5 by 33.5 by 21 millimeters in a silicone case that protects it from water droplets, and a probe measuring 84.5 millimeters in length and 30 millimeters in width, which is inserted into the soil. The sensor is fairly large, partly due to the use of AAA batteries. For scale, here it is next to a regular matchbox. On one side of the probe, you can see the conductors used to measure soil moisture levels. The temperature sensor is located in the main body of the device. The back of the probe is smooth. As a reminder, for accurate measurements, it should be inserted into the soil at least 2/3 of its length. The silicone case is removable. Its purpose is to protect the main module from splashes and water droplets. Also, the sensor's body should not touch the soil. There are slots on the sides of the sensor that allow you to open the battery compartment cover. Under the cover, in addition to the compartments for 2 AAA batteries, there is a button. Hold it for 6 seconds to put the sensor into pairing mode. The blinking LED next to it will indicate this mode. Here it is next to one of my first soil sensors from Xiaomi, which operates via Bluetooth. It also has a long probe and, in addition to temperature and moisture, displays soil fertility readings. The sensor's body is much smaller because it uses a CR2032 battery. The sensor is now in pairing mode. You can see the LED blinking. Let's start the software part with the native ecosystem, Tuya Smart. Everything works similarly in Smart Life. For the connection, I'm using a Zigbee Thread Gateway with Matter support. There's a link to its review in the video description. Zigbee devices are added via quick pairing mode. Next, the gateway begins searching, and the sensor must be in pairing mode. The gateway detects and connects to it. Here it is in the device list, with the Zigbee logo shown on its tile. I found a couple of pots with soil but no plants. I'll use them for testing. The soil is currently completely dry. I'm inserting the probe in such a way that the main body of the sensor stays above the soil. As expected, the moisture reading is zero, which is correct. The temperature was initially displayed in Fahrenheit. In the lower right corner, there's a settings button. It opens a menu where you can change the temperature unit. I set it to Celsius. The status and battery level are also displayed here. Now let's try watering the soil and check the sensor's readings. Here's the history of the readings from left to right. Right after watering, the moisture level showed 100% because the sensor is placed right in the center of the pot, and I watered directly near it. As seen from the timestamp at the top left of each screenshot, 45 minutes later the moisture dropped to 91% as the water spread throughout the pot. Another 30 minutes later, it stabilized at 76%. Let's go to the data history tab. There are graphs of readings by day, month, and year. Besides these menus, there are general settings, standard options like sharing, compatibility, firmware check, home screen shortcut, and device removal. Now let's move on to the automation section. The sensor can only be used as a trigger, which makes sense since it doesn't perform any actions. Three trigger types are available: battery level, temperature, and humidity readings. For each of these, you can set a value and a condition: greater than, less than, or equal to. When the threshold is reached, the automation will be triggered. As I mentioned, I connected the sensor to a Zigbee thread gateway with Matter support, through which it is connected in bridge mode to Apple HomeKit. More details are in my video. The link is in the description. If you go to Settings, then to Hubs and Bridges, and select this gateway, in the Accessories section you will see that a temperature and humidity sensor with two sensors has appeared. In essence, the soil sensor is a temperature and humidity sensor, so the system combines it with other similar devices in the room, which affects the overall readings in the climate section. Therefore, it is better to create a separate location for plants. And while the temperature readings still somewhat fit into the overall picture, the humidity readings vary much more widely. But the main thing is that the sensor readings are correctly transmitted via Matter, even though this was not officially declared. This is definitely a plus. Matter capabilities allow simultaneous connection of several systems. So in addition to HomeKit, the gateway also serves as a bridge for Home Assistant, using the integration of the same name. The sensor, as expected, appeared here as well. That means it is now working simultaneously in Tuya Smart, Apple HomeKit, and Home Assistant. At the same time, Matter works locally and does not depend on the internet. On the left, we can see that the device is connected through a wired Matter gateway. In the center are the sensor readings: temperature, humidity, battery level. In the column on the right will be the history of changes in the state of objects. Another system to which this gateway is connected in bridge mode is Google Home. This point did not make it into my review of the Zigbee Thread gateway, but the method is completely identical to adding it to Home Assistant. In HomeKit, where the gateway is connected first, activate pairing mode in its settings, after which Google Home detects it on its own. I'm using Google Nest 2. The shown code is used for pairing. This test was conducted later than the previous ones, so the readings differ from those just shown, but as seen in the screenshot on the right, they match those displayed at the current time. As a result, thanks to Matter, the readings from the sensor are simultaneously available in Tuya Smart, Apple HomeKit, Home Assistant, and Google Home. Now let's move on to alternative systems. I removed the sensor from the gateway through the General Settings menu in Tuya Smart, and it was automatically removed from the other systems as well. Let's check compatibility with the Sonoff iHost Smart Home Controller. The current firmware version at the time of testing was 2.5.1. iHost is equipped with its own Zigbee coordinator, which allows it to connect devices directly, even from other ecosystems. Let me remind you, it belongs to the Yealink system. The sensor was detected and connected. It is displayed as a 4-button switch. However, the main thing is not the image, but the data from it. The E icon in the upper right corner of its tile means that this is an end device, i.e. it cannot transmit data from other nodes. Also, a battery icon is shown, and, which is nice, temperature readings are displayed. Humidity readings were also found inside. At the time of connection, I was holding the sensor in my hands, having taken it out of the pot. Therefore, the humidity readings sharply dropped to 12%. Then I returned it back to the pot, and as seen in the screenshots, less than a minute passed, the humidity readings quickly increased. Also available here is the history of changes in temperature and humidity readings. The menu at the top of the window allows you to select a time range for viewing data, and it is possible to export the data to a local file. In the General Settings menu, you can change the device name, set the location, configure the temperature scale, view battery level and signal quality, and remove the device from the system. The sensor can participate in automations as a trigger and event generator. Here you can enable and use thresholds for temperature and humidity. In the Actions section, the sensor is not available. iHost also supports the Matter protocol, but here I have only one connection to Google Home. Unfortunately, Google Home does not have a pairing mode option like HomeKit, so only one system is available. To use it in several systems, you need to delete this connection and start with HomeKit, following the method I showed in the review of the Tuya gateway. The sensor appeared in Google Home. However, unlike the Matter connection through the gateway, only the temperature parameter was transferred. The humidity, the main parameter of this sensor, is missing. Now we return to Home Assistant and check the operation of the sensor through alternative coordinators and systems. This is the standard Zigbee integration, JA. Here I am using the SkyConnect USB Zigbee coordinator, updated to the current version at the time of testing. The sensor, previously removed from iHost, is switched to pairing mode, and in JA we launched the device pairing mode. More details on working with this integration are covered in my video tutorial. The link is in the description under the video. The sensor is supported normally. Right after connection, the humidity readings were not displayed. This happens, it's normal. You just need to wait a bit for the update to arrive. This screenshot was taken literally a minute later. The sensor is in my hands. I wiped the probe from the soil, so the humidity is zero, as it should be. Another minute later, the sensor is back in the pot. The data was updated. While the moisture hasn't distributed evenly, the readings may differ significantly, even if you just place it in another spot in the same pot. Here I moved it to another, also unused pot with dry soil. The reading is 2%, which fully matches expectations. Immediately after watering, the readings jumped to 100%. The sensor instantly reacted to the presence of water. Now let's check compatibility with Zigbee 2 MQTT. I also made video tutorials about this add-on. The link to the current one is in the description under the video. The current version at the time of testing was 2.2.1. There were no problems with connection here either. The sensor was correctly recognized and added to the system. Detailed information about the device. A correct image, manufacturer identifiers, model code. Temperature and humidity are available. I have now returned the sensor to the pot I watered first, placing it not in the center, but closer to the edge. There is a toggle for temperature scale. Don't be confused by the battery level. During testing, I used lithium rechargeable batteries, which I charged quite a while ago. Here is how the data from the sensor looks in Home Assistant, where it is transferred via the MQTT integration. I decided not to touch the sensor and just observe its readings for a while. As a reference point, we'll take the moment when I changed the temperature scale. At the time of this screenshot, 16 seconds had passed. The next screenshot, as can be seen from the same event, was taken 16 hours later. Visually, the readings didn't change much, but everything becomes more clear on the graphs. This is the change in humidity. For a while it increased. This is explained by the fact that the sensor was placed closer to the edge and I watered in the center. Then it held at one level for several hours. apparently having evenly distributed throughout the entire volume of soil. After that, the level began to gradually drop due to natural reasons. And this is the temperature graph. I moved the pot to the windowsill, where it's cooler. This is visible as a sharp drop on the graph. Then there were slight fluctuations during the night, and in the morning, the temperature started to rise slightly. At the same time, as you can see, the sensor sends values that differ by tenths of a degree, although for some models this change is too minor to send data. From what I've seen, I believe that the sensor is quite suitable for its intended purposes, but it would be better to place it slightly to the side from the watering spot. Depending on the care requirements of each specific plant, you can determine the thresholds through experimentation, upon reaching which, notifications can be sent and watering triggered automatically. The advantages of the sensor include its support in all tested management systems, including data forwarding via matter, fast enough data updates, reaction to temperature changes by 1/10 of a degree. Overall, the sensor is worth attention and at least testing in real conditions. That's all for now. I hope the video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes. They help with YouTube promotion. And if you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the description under the video, I will leave links to all the mentioned resources, as well as to my Telegram channels and social networks, groups for discussing smart home topics. Join in, it will be interesting. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Peace to everyone.